हाय फ्रेंड्स, सो टुडे आई वांट टू शेयर अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट व्हेन पीपल टॉक अबाउट नार्सिसिज्म एंड द ट्विन फ्लेम जर्नी. एक्सक्यूज मी. सो यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड देर आर अ लॉट ऑफ लाइफ कोचेज आउट देर, अ लॉट ऑफ मेंटल हेल्थ एंड रिलेशनशिप प्रोफेशनल्स हु से दैट अ ट्विन फ्लेम पाथ इज गेटिंग योर सेल्फ इन टू अ टॉक्सिक रिलेशनशिप. एंड फ्रॉम अ लिमिटेड फाइव सेंसेस लोअर परस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द 3D डायमेंशन दे आर करेक्ट. ओके, बट इफ दे हैव द कैपेसिटी टू थिंक इन टर्म्स ऑफ अ मल्टी डिमेंशनल सेल्फ, इन टर्म्स ऑफ द 5D सेल्फ, यू नो द फिफ्थ डिमेंशन, देन दे कैन सी हाउ दे आर रॉन्ग. ओके, एज रिगार्ड्स टू अ ट्विन फ्लेम जर्नी. ओके, बिकॉज सी ट्विन फ्लेम्स दे आर अ 5D बींग. ओके, एंड वेन वी टॉक अबाउट द डिवाइन मैस्कुलाइन, रियली द डिवाइन मैस्कुलाइन डजेंट कम डाउन टू अ नॉन डिवाइन प्लेस. ओके, बिकॉज द डिवाइन मैस्कुलाइन इज बेसिकली द आइडेंटिटी एंड द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ 5D. ओके, सो इफ ही लीव्स दैट एंड ही कम्स डाउन हियर, ही बिकम्स द शेडो मैस्कुलाइन इन 3D. ओके, सो इन 3D देर इज नो सच थिंग एज अ डिवाइन मैस्कुलाइन. ओके, देर इज अ वॉनबी डिवाइन मैस्कुलाइन एंड देर इज अ वॉनबी डिवाइन फेमिनाइन, बट द डिवाइन मैस्कुलाइन एंड द डिवाइन फेमिनाइन दे डोंट एग्जिस्ट इन 3D. वॉट एग्जिस्ट इन 3D इज जस्ट अ होलोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ योर डिवाइन मैस्कुलाइन. ओके, विच वी कॉल DM or divine masculine or the shadow twin flame, okay, or the matrix twin flame. So yeah, in one aspect they are completely right, because as long as you have not completed your journey and as long as you have not integrated your masculine feminine, you're going to get a holographic projection of your divine masculine that is negative. Okay, we will use these terms, we will continue using these terms, divine masculine and divine feminine, irrespective of whether the person is at the 3D level or the 5D level for now, because this is the twin flame journey and it is the journey of the divine masculine and the divine feminine. Okay, so yes, they are right. Okay, especially if you are in a matrix twin flame connection, it is very important to maintain distance from this person. Okay, because it is not your divine masculine, it is not your twin flame, it is a holographic projection. Okay, and I want you all to get this very, very clear. So the divine masculine is actually available to you in your reality timeline post samadhis, post the third eye balancing. Okay, so your third eye has to not only just activate but balance, meaning your kundalini has to raise up and stay up. Okay, now this is for those who are on the ascension journey, the kundalini ascension journey. Okay, for a lot of twin flames, see, there are different types of twin flame, and what I'm telling might not be applicable to all the twin flames. Like what I'm telling now is more for those who are in the matrix twin flame connection, although I talk about other twin flame connections also in my videos. So in the matrix twin flame connection, what happens is the matrix twin flame heals at the end. Okay, so in other twin flame connections, what happens is simultaneously the healing takes place. Okay, so like your kundalini awakens and then his might awaken simultaneously after some time, after maybe a 2-3 years his might awaken. So that is a different type of twin flame connection. Okay, and then there are other connections where you heal a little bit over there and then this other person heals. Okay, so that there is that kind of a mirroring. So to a certain degree, a healthy relationship is possible in this kind of a situation, provided you know how to navigate it. Okay, so that is the reason you have all this life coaching and all these people who teach all these things in detail, so that you are able to navigate it without much waste of time and energy. Okay, because once you have the direction, you can navigate it. Okay, without direction, how will you navigate? And getting direction regarding your particular twin flame situation, your particular type of twin flame rich situation is very difficult. It takes time. It will take time. Okay, so I was talking about the matrix twin flame connection. So actually, I would like to introduce a new concept here. It is not a new concept as in the spiritual circles, but on my channel I've not spoken about it before. Okay, so there is something called NPCs. Okay, and NPCs means non-player characters. Okay, now I think this term was first coined by Dolores Cannon. Okay, by Dolores Cannon, and she has a series of books called Convoluted Universe. I think I am get remembering that it right. The Convoluted Universe. Okay, so here she has gathered all this information through deep hypnosis from her clients. Okay, when the superconscious level of the client would start speaking with her, start communicating with Dolores, so she would ask them questions about all. This is just like going into deep meditative states and getting your answers from your higher self. Okay, but the only difference in this case was Dolores would get all the answers and information from the hypnosis state, deep hypnosis state, and there is a particular name for her system. You know, I think it is called quantum hypnosis or something like that. Okay, so it's a very interesting model for those who, want to get into the deeper states of consciousness without going on the spirituality path. Like they are more into science and those kinds of things. So that's another interesting option. You can go for such sessions and connect with your higher self as well. Okay. So coming back to this term that I was using, non-player characters. So non-player characters refer to in your particular reality hologram. Okay, there are a lot of people that are kind of not real. Okay, as in they are not fully embodied. Their entire soul is not fully embodied, so they are partial projections of the soul, as in they are not real people. Okay, they are kind of like programs. The best way to understand is this is watch the Matrix movie, you'll understand. So in that movie there is something called energy harvesting. Okay, so people are put into this fake world, a fake hologram. Okay, and actually in reality they are in a prison, they are in a prison system, so they don't know that they are in the prison system. Okay, and then you have the agents of the Matrix. So the agents of the Matrix, anybody can be an agent. Okay, anybody can be an agent, and you start noticing them as you get closer to awakening your third eye. Okay, because that is when all the attacks happen. Okay, because they sense that your energy level has gone beyond a certain level, so the agents can holographically project themselves through anyone. Okay, and you can see all these things only when your third eye awakens, you know, when all your chakras have cleared and you can basically understand the structure of reality, how reality operates. Then you can notice when the agents come in and when the agents try to manipulate you or attack you. Okay, so yeah, watch the movie and you will understand when I mean what I mean by soulless beings. Okay. And they are called non-player characters, NPCs, or soulless beings. Okay, so for our video conversation, we are just going to use the term soulless beings. Okay, so actually this is what the narcissism in the twin flame relationship is really about. The Matrix twin flame or the divine masculine, who's not really divine masculine, as long as you are in 3D, is actually a soulless being. Okay, and this is the reason you should stay away. Okay, you should stay away from them. Okay, now if you have an interaction with them, what is going to happen is they're going to trigger all the issues that need healing. So in that respect, if you're approaching this person in that respect to get a mirroring and a deep understanding of your psychology, your unconscious, whatever you need to heal in your unconscious and activate your DNA, for that reason this person is excellent, because they exactly mirror to you whatever issues need healing. Okay, but this is a very very 3D way of healing. It is okay, it's like one of the last choices you can take. You know, the best way to healing is to go into some deep मेडिटेटिव प्रैक्टिस लाइक क्रिया योगा और टेक अप सम फॉर्म ऑफ साधना. ओके, बिकॉज दिस इज अबाउट यू एंड यू, सो दैट यू कैन गेट आउट ऑफ दिस फेक होलोग्राम दैट इज ऑल अराउंड यू. ओके, बिकॉज यू कैन नॉट एक्सेस द रियल वर्ल्ड, देर इज अ फ्रिक्वेंसी फेंस अराउंड यू. ओके, यू कैन नॉट एक्सेस योर डिवाइन मैस्कुलिन, यू कैन नॉट एक्सेस योर सोल फैमिली एज लॉन्ग एज दैट फ्रिक्वेंसी फेंस इज अराउंड यू. ओके, एंड यू माइट सी देयर बॉडीज अराउंड बट दोज आर होलोग्राम्स एज आई से दे आर द सोललेस बींग्स. दे आर द सोललेस बींग्स एंड योर मेट्रिक्स ट्विन फ्लेम और योर डिवाइन मैस्कुलिन टू अ लार्ज एक्सटेंट. ओके, स्पेशली इन केस ऑफ द मेट्रिक्स ट्विन फ्लेम इज अ सोललेस बींग. सो देर इज जस्ट अ बॉडी देर एंड देर इज अ सर्टन अमाउंट ऑफ प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ द सोल इन साइड दैट बॉडी सो एज टू ऑपरेट इट. ओके, बिकॉज इट्स लाइक अ सॉफ्टवेयर प्रोग्राम दैट इज ऑपरेटिंग. ओके, बट द हायर चक्रज द अपर चक्रज आर यूजली ब्लॉक्ड. सो वॉट हैपन्स इज देर आर एंटिटी अटैचमेंट्स. ओके, सो बेसिकली वेन यू इंटरैक्ट विथ योर मेट्रिक्स ट्विन फ्लेम यू आर इंटरैक्टिंग विथ अ ग्रुप ऑफ एंटिटीज. ओके, एंड अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम यू नोटिस सच पीपल दैट समटाइम्स यू टेल देम समथिंग एंड देन नेक्स्ट टाइम दे डोंट रिमेंबर इट बिकॉज there was one entity that time and now there is another entity there. Okay, so these people are like, you know, they are like shells of people. Okay, they are soulless beings because their entire soul has not embodied within them. And the reason you are even attracted to such people is because your entire soul is not fully embodied either. Okay, so this is just a holographic world that we are seeing that is not real because of the soul fragmentation. Okay, so only when your soul is whole can you get the real projection of what the real world is, which happens when your third eye opens and balances. Okay, so for this reason I would like to advise all my viewers to stay away from your divine masculine or you know, the matrix twin flame. It could be the male energy, it could be the female energy, whoever's holding the shadow part and not doing the work, whose job is just to mirror it to you. Stay away from this person until your third eye is awakened, because your divine masculine is at that level. Okay, here we are talking about reality holograms. Okay, you're not going to access the real world until you bring your Kundalini to the third eye. If you are a true twin flame, your Kundalini awakening has to happen. Now, there is another thing I would like to mention here, and that is there are a lot of twin flame pairs. For them, it is not necessary to keep their Kundalini raised. It's not necessary to have a Kundalini awakening. It's not necessary to keep your Kundalini raised, what is called as chakra bedhan. That is also not necessary, okay? What is necessary is your chakras have to be cleared and balanced to a certain extent, meaning all heavy karma should be cleared and it should be balanced, and you should know how to have balanced energetic exchanges with your twin and with the world, okay? So that is all that is necessary, and then all your chakras are clear, balanced, start spinning correctly. Even if your Kundalini is not risen, you can still have the reunion. There are so many twin flame pairs that are in reunion, in physical reunion, even when the Kundalini is not raised. Okay, so I have to mention that. So this is why I tell you time and again, you have to figure out what type of twin flame connection, you know, and there is not much information out there. Okay, because the management structure that you are going to follow for your relationship is going to be based on identifying your type of connection. Okay, what type of twin flame connection it is. Okay, in the case of starseed twin flames, for us, the bar is very high. The bar is very high because we come from a different dimension, okay, and we have the tools to get there. Okay, it doesn't mean that it happens fast, it takes a long time, because to reach a high level, of course, you need time. It doesn't happen in 6 months or 1 year, it takes many, many years. But that is how it is with us, okay. So we have to reach a certain level, and in our case, we have to embody our monad self also. okay, and we have to do something that is called chakra bhedan, which means the kundalini stays risen in your crown chakra and then it circulates back into the root, so you have that kind of a movement. Okay, so and then you have to ground this energy also, okay, by balancing the practical and the spiritual, otherwise you start getting all these issues. So that is how we shift into 5D, basically through grounding it, so you activate all the higher chakras and then you ground it. The moment you ground it, your physical reality changes, okay, and when your physical reality changes, you ascend out of the 3D matrix into the 5D soul matrix, okay, and that is where you have your reunion, okay, at the level of the third eye. So this takes many years, okay. In astrology, there is something known as the Kal Sarpa Dosha. Actually, a Kal Sarpa Dosha is for a lot of people it is a curse, but it is for twin flames, it is just a sadhana period. So till year 35, you're doing your spiritual sadhana, you're cleaning your systems till you get to the 5D timelines. Because all your professional support, all your friendship support, all your twin flame, everything exists at that level, okay, beyond the matrix, okay. So the only thing that we have to do is focus on how to clean the DNA and retrieve all our soul DNA. That's the only way to access your divine masculine. Okay, because that is a 5D being. Okay, that is a 5D being, and the code of the divine masculine is 1212. Okay, so if you see 1212, you should understand that maybe your divine masculine is trying to connect with you, and the code of the divine feminine is 1010. Okay, so when you start getting, usually when all your karma is cleared, you start seeing 1010. Okay, that means you have finally reached the divine feminine status, because as long as we are in 3D and we are carrying with the collective karma or ancestral karma, we are not divine feminine. Okay, so you have to reach that status. Okay, so this video was mainly to discuss all the narcissism that people talk about in the twin flame journey. It is correct, it is true. So for this reason, you should stay away from this person, from the 3D holographic version of this person. Okay, you should stay away. I should use the right terms. You should stay away from the 3D holographic matrix twin flame or shadow version of this person. Do your sadhana, raise your kundalini, heal all your junk DNA, heal your unconscious mind. Okay, and when your third eye is balanced, only then you can access the divine masculine, and that is the time when this person completely heals. Either their kundalini awakens, or there is another process that happens where the divine feminine monadic mother, she absorbs the entire karma of the divine masculine, and then there is a rebirth process. Okay, there's a rebirth process, and then the kundalini awakens in this divine masculine. So either he awakens spiritually, like his kundalini awakens, he awakens on his own, or his entire karma is absorbed by the monadic divine mother, divine feminine, monadic divine feminine. The entire karma is absorbed by her, and then the kundalini rises, and he has a total rebirth. Or third, there is a walk-in experience. Walk-in experience meaning there is a death of the 3D self, okay, of the which what I say the soulless being, okay. Even though I say the soulless being, that entity still has karmic baggage, okay. So there is a complete death of this 3D soulless being, and the monadic self walks in. So there is a walk-in experience, okay. So either these three things can happen when your third eye awakens, but in reality, I feel that what really happens is the 3D soulless being continues on the 3D timeline. Okay, it is you who ascends to the 5D timeline. You getting me? And from your perspective, it appears like there is a walk-in experience, like there is a death of the 3D soul self, and there is a 5D walk-in experience. Okay, because you have shifted to 5D. Okay, that version of him is still on the 3D timelines. Okay, and after your third eye fully balances, you can access the future and you can access the past, and then you can sort through shift through the timelines, and you can actually see that that soulless being still exists. What we call the matrix twins still exist. What we say the narcissistic person, they still exist on the 3D timelines. Okay, so you have left that holographic reality and you have ascended to 5D. So yes, in my opinion, like, stay away from this person. Do your work. Your focus has to be on your goal. Okay, you have to just be focused on your goal. Okay, and once your third eye balances, then you don't have to go and communicate to him, because already the communication will happen telepathically. You can actually see, you can actually hear your 5D twin flame, and within some time, the physical version will also come to you, but it will not be the old narcissistic soulless being. It will be the monadic twin flame or the 5D twin flame. Okay, so this is what I have to share with you today on narcissism and twin flame relationships, divine masculines, and all of that. So if you like my work, please give me a like, thumbs up, share this video, and if you like my artworks, then you can order some. You can order a print also, and please subscribe to my channel. Okay. So, sending you lots of love, and I will see you again next time.